have to be very careful about how we interpret what we read, especially the Bible. And I'll tell you why. When I research these secret societies, and I research the Bible, and by the way, I'm a Christian, so if you're a Christian, don't think I'm knocking your religion. I'm not. I'm just telling you what I found. I have found that at the very heart and core of all these secret societies lurks the Kabbalah. The Kabbalah is the ancient Jewish mysticism. It is a method of encoding information through a system of mathematics and numbers.
Okay, well, if you've got the time code 1111 and you multiply it by the same thing, so 1111 times 1111,
yeah,
you get the number 1234321.
Okay,
so
yeah.
If you imagine that as a visual, you've got a pyramid.
So yeah? One step up, that's number one. Then you have two, that's two steps up. Is that, yeah, is that what you're going at here?
Yeah, yeah. So essentially, like, because you've got the 1234321, if you were to plot that on a graph,
right,
on an X and a Y, you'd have a pyramid.
Interesting.
So, and the same decreases, so if you've got 111, you times it by 111, you get 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. You get a pyramid, whichever way you look at it, anything with a base of 1.
Interesting.
And so then, if you look at the 11 itself, and in binary, an 11 stands for a 3. So obviously you've got a trinity out of it.
Hmm.
Do you know what I mean? So if you were to convert to binary, it would mean it'd be 3. So essentially, then if you look at this idea of the trinity with it, you know, 33rd degree Masons,
oh,
and
yeah,
the number 33 that goes around? Obviously, if you turn that into the Trinity and you divide 33 by 3, you get 11.
That's interesting.
So you start like seeing these 11s, as I'm saying. So then you move on to recent events, and you get to September the 11th, 2001, right?
Yeah.
And you realise that the building was stood like an 11. The two towers stood like an 11.
Indeed.
And then you've got 9/11, which is 9 plus 1 plus 1, which is 11. And then you realise that September the 11th was 111 days until the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And then you start thinking about the first plane that hit the World Trade Center, and it was Flight 11.
There you go, yeah.
Right, and the total number of crew on Flight 11 was 11. And then you look into it further, and the New York State was the 11th state of the US Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and so then you start thinking about where September the 11th stands in year, as far as years are concerned, and September the 11th, 2001, stands 11 years from 2012.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. And there's an author called Jose Argueles. He wrote that from 1992 to 2012 would be in a period of May of no time, the time of no time. which was a transition of the ages kind of period in which, you know, basically world disasters and tension would be on the up and rise constantly. And this period of no time was 1992 to 2012. And so 9/11 in September the 11th, 2001, was 9 years from the start of no time, 11 years till the end of no time.
Mm-hmm.
So, synchronistically, it was placed bang on where, you know, it should have been. You look into it further, and World Trade Center commenced building in 1966 and finished building it in 1977. So it took 11 years to create as well.
Yeah.
So you can move on from that and forget all that for the time being, and then you can get to September the 11th in history. And on September the 11th, 1990, at 9:09 p.m., that's 11 years prior to 9/11, George Bush Sr. made his very first speech entitled "Towards a New World Order" in the UN, you know, at the UN.
Mm.
So this was 11 years prior. Mm. And then if you take that back 60 years, so you go back to September the 11th, 1941, you'll realise that 60 years to 9/11, that was when the soil was broken for the Pentagon.
Pentagon, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And so you've got this date, September the 11th, again running through this kind of, you know, the nasty war machine of America, if you want to call it that.
Exactly.
And so then, basically, there's something that happened much further back in time than that. And there's a book written in 1981, and it was called The Birth of Christ Recalculated. And it was written by a guy called Ernest L. Martin. And he claims to have calculated the exact date of Jesus Christ's birthday based on celestial charts for that era.
Yeah.
Basically, he's worked out with the famous Star of Bethlehem, which was, you know, he worked out that essentially Jesus Christ was born on September the 11th, 3 BC. And this book was released in 1981.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we've got another date there.
I think that is, sorry to interrupt there, but I think that's actually a key area to why we potentially are seeing so many things oriented around the 9 and the 11 September.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Look at the time.
11:10.
It's 11:11. I was wearing that when I was in my car accident.
Didn't walk away without a scratch.
It's the time of death on David's death certificate.
Mom, the date she died, November the 11th.
Brother, be careful looking for meaning where there is none.
At 11:12 p.m.
11 plus 12.
23.
My birthday, 2-3.
Driver's license, social security number.
It's all 23.
As if it's imitating my life.
You've concerned yourself with minutiae and you've drawn wild conclusions from them.
Every 23rd word on every 23rd page.
I warn you, hell is waiting.
Why are you showing me this?
It's a list of dates.
Every major global disaster for the last 50 years in perfect sequence.
From a piece of paper that's been buried in the ground for 5 decades.
The next number on the chain predicts that tomorrow, 81 people are going to die in some kind of tragedy.
Get off the train.
Why? What's wrong?
Just take the baby and get off the train.
Estimates put the presumed dead at 81.
The prediction came true. It's not coincidence.
The numbers are a warning. They're a warning to everyone.
This is not a test. This is an emergency broadcast transmission.
We're going to stay on the air for as long as possible.